No princess! She can't be found.
Have you seen Strawberry?
No, but I found her baton in the cafe.
She's not in any of the shops.
And we've looked everywhere.
What if she quit? Why would anyone give up being the very best princess?
Well, she did mention having a lot of tasks.
Well, I did my task. Sorta.
Yeah, I kinda let her down too, I guess.
She asked me to do just one little thing, and I just kept asking her to help me. And I didn't even say please.
Girls, I think we all got so wrapped up in our little projects and what we needed that we didn't even pay attention to what Strawberry needed.
No wonder she took off. If I was her, I'd quit too.
I was so selfish. She kept asking us to help each other, and instead we were just rude to each other.
I was mean.
And she only asked us to do one little thing.
And I messed it up with my rhinestones.
No, no. It was all me with my silly glitter. Trying to have the best wing. Why didn't we just help each other out like she asked?
Here, please take my hanky.
Thank you.
We're all to blame. And after Strawberry worked so hard.
What a great leader. Never complained.
Always polite.
Heart of gold. And she cared so much about us having fun.
And now she's left us.
I can still hear her pleading voice in my memory.
Please?
Wait! That voice is real!
Look! Up there!
Hey! Over here!
Whoa! Well, we've just gotta save her! Come on, everyone!
Grab that garland! Please!
Oh, I'll take this wing!
Get down.
Grab and pull, please.
Gather round.
Grab and pull, please.
Pull her down.
Grab and pull.
To the ground.
Grab and pull.
Safe and sound. Yay!
Now, why were you grinning up there, Strawberry?
Well, high on that branch, I watched you all march here to my rescue. I wish you could have seen it. Marching and singing and carrying garlands. It looked like a lot of fun.
It was a lot of fun. Once we worked together and were nice to each other.
Girls, I was worried for a minute we wouldn't have a parade. But you just gave me the best parade ever.
We did? We did! Yay!
Be clear about this.
Strawberry, it was you who made this parade happen. You never gave up, even when no one was helpful. And we all thank you from the very bottom of our hearts.
Oh, you're making me feel like a real princess.
Don't let anyone see you. Don't let anyone see you. So, I was thinking maybe the green stripe would look better.
hear something?
No. Oh, I thought I heard something. Yeah. Secret gift I get, though it can't be nearly as great as the one I gave Lemon. Oh, I wonder what it is! Wow, a book! A book about organizing books? Chapter 72, Big Books and Little Books, Together on One Shelf? Not as impossible as it seems? What am I gonna do with this? But it is the biggest First Frost gift ever. I got it! This is the perfect secret gift for my secret giftie. Plum! She's gonna love it! So, you know, I just thought and thought about what to give my secret giftie, Mr. Longface. Something he would really, really like. Thanks, Pupcake. And then it hit me, a plant for the entrance to his croquet club. And I know just the perfect plant. Oh, oops, almost forgot my rope.
Wow! That's the most ginormous First Frost gift I've ever seen!
I knew that was a good choice for Plum!
Oh, nice! A book! Chapter 137, Sorting Your Encyclopedias. The A to Z of How To and How Not To. Maybe not exactly the most must-have gift I've ever received for First Frost.
I know! My secret giftie Orange likes to sort things. I bet she'd love this!
Indeed, yes. It is getting chilly these days, Miss Jadybug. You know, I have an extra hat you could borrow. Very warm.
Hello? Well, hello! Aren't you the most wonderfully oversized First Frost gift?
Grab and move. Grab and move. Here it is! Mr. Longface will be thrilled when he sees his gift. And I'm gonna get it for him. No matter what.
Ta-da! Raspberry will love a gift this big. She could use it as a footstool when she sews. Or to hide a refrigerator.
I did it! Oh, Mr. Longface is gonna love you, little plant. Oh, muffin crumbs!
You there! Why do the plants look like this?
That's the mystery. Something's making them turn plaid and polka-dotted. But I'm sure you can find the answer in one of your books.
No. I'm going to solve this case the Patty Persimmon way. And she always begins by gathering clues. And then comes the fun part.
Fun part?
Yes, getting into the mind of the criminal. Asking herself how a criminal thinks. Why would plants want to be Polka Dot and Plaid? Maybe they were bored.
Aha! I know what's wrong with these plants.
Someone has been painting them.
Why would anybody do that?
Exactly! That is what I'm going to find out. I'm going to wait for the criminal to return to the scene of the crime. They always do that, you know. I learned it from Patty Persimmon, genius detective. I'll stay out here all night if I have to. Not a thing will escape my keen eye. And the other one, too.
Oh my, this is very bad. There are even more plaids and polka dots now.
Well, hey, maybe Blueberry solved the mystery. Where is she anyway?
She was around here somewhere.
Blueberry?
Huh?
Aha! You there! So it was you all along! And your criminal accomplice! This case is solved! So, what made you do it?
Do what?
Paint plaids and spots on the berry plants.
We didn't paint anything.
Then what are you doing here in the middle of the night?
We came to check on you, to make sure you were okay. Actually, it's morning now.
Aha! I knew that. I just wanted to see if you knew that I knew. You know? Now, if you'll excuse me, I have a mystery to solve. Somewhere out here is a master criminal, a fiend with no sense of fashion.
Oh, no. What are we going to do about Blueberry?
We never see her anymore.
And even when she's here, she's not really here. She's pretending to be Patty Persimmon.
Yeah, I think I just may have an idea. Now, I'll need everybody's help. So, what was the name of the There's another mystery, Blueberry. One that has us all stumped.
Well, I am still working on the spotted plaid plant mystery. But I think I can fit another one in. In the multiple mulberries mystery, Patty Persimmon juggled 10 cases at the same time and solved them all. She's just so great. So, you there, what's the new mystery?
Well, it's sort of a missing person case.
Aha! Why would a person go missing? As Patty Persimmon would say, time to get a clue or two. This missing person, they haven't been seen recently?
You might say that.
Aha! I knew it! Now, what is their favorite color?
Favorite color? Blue!
If it was Wednesday...
It is Wednesday.
Where might I find this person on a Wednesday? I mean, if they weren't missing.
At the cafe? At book club?
Say no more. Your missing person is as good as found.
Running. If they can't run the berry works,
then no one is making glimmerberry juice.
What happens to Berry Bitty City when the juice runs out?
Oh, this is absolutely awful. I thought making the berrykins bigger would be helpful. I didn't think I'd be affecting all of Berry Bitty City.
Right now, we're the only ones small enough to run the berry works.
You know, you're right. Just show me what to do. I helped cause this problem. Now I'm gonna help fix it.
I'll help too.
Me too. too. Me too. Let's go, girls. All right.
Raspberry, we're going to need more of your perfume.
But the princess needs me to help run the berry works. And besides, I'm much too small to reach any of the flowers.
That's not so. Even though we're bitty,
we can do big things!
Especially if some of the berrykins reach the flowers for you.
Oh, I just thought of something. While we're running the berry works, who's gonna run our shops?
Fruit salad! Coming up as soon as I figure out how to make it! Where's my waffle?
Two cups of tea on table five.
Where's the waffle?
Or is that table
four? How do you make a waffle?
Don't ask me. I've never cooked before.
Neither have I. Running away!
Look at all of these.
What do we do?
Where are they supposed to go?
I know. We'll sort them by color.
He's right.
Dips on green.
What a great idea.
So, what do we do?
Whatever the berrykins used to do. Come on.
That one.
I sure wish we could do it the way the berrykins do it. They make it look so easy, but it's not.
I tried to change you just to make things easier for me. Oh, I ended up making things awful for all of Berry Bitty City.
And now we'll mix another batch to change you and your friends back to normal.
The Berrykins are back!
Phew! And back to normal.
Gone yet?
Yeah. Why?
The postmaster just heard that the storm we had the other night, it blocked the road to Acorn Acres. She won't be able to get through.
Oh, no! Strawberry? Strawberry, come back!
Very good, Pupcake.
But even if we could clear the road, it'd take us too long. Oh, I think the only thing to do is keep going without the scooter. To Rosevale, Brookville, and that must be the way to Acorn Acres. Great. Now which way should I go?
I keep telling them they should fix this thing, but do they listen?
Because you didn't ask nice.
What do you know about nice?
Nice is my middle name.
No, it isn't.
Excuse?
Yeah, yes.
Is not.
Okay, what is my middle name then?
Ladybird. Your name's Sadiebug, Ladybird, Berry Beetle.
How did you know that?
Girls?
Because maybe I've known you all your life and I'm your twin sister.
My luck. If someone had asked me, I would have picked a different twin sister.
Me too. Or I'd pick triplets. But none of them would have been you.
Hello? Well, don't just stand there.
We need your help.
You certainly aren't talking to me. Are you?
We most very certainly are.
Certainly, for certain.
Oh, well, what can I help you with?
Can't you see?
Sorry, but, you're gonna have to tell me.
Let's make her guess.
Silly, stop fooling around. This is serious.
Well, I have a serious, thing, too. And, oh, can you tell me how to get to Acorn Acres?
We've lost our picnic!
What?
It grew away from us.
Grew away?
And we're really hungry.
I'm hungrier.
I said it first.
Doesn't mean you were hungrier first.
Girls, please, please explain. How did your picnic grow away?
Well, we were looking for a place to have our picnic.
And I had some great ideas, but she wouldn't listen.
Because my ideas were best.
And while you were discussing, the flower grew up where you left your picnic things?
And now our picnic is up there!
And we're down here.
Like the song, I
love it. Did you try that new berry shake at the cafe?
Oh, yeah. Good.
Hey, by the way, where is Strawberry?
Hi, everybody.
Strawberry.
Hi, Strawberry. Hello. Oh, am I early?
Right on time. I'm just running a bit behind. Let's see. Sorry, Blueberry. Can I put you over here? Let me put you over here. Tea?
Thank you.
And let's get those pinkies soaking.
How much time do we have?
We're running out of time. I wish there was a way to do hair and nails faster. I don't want to be late for the special event.
Lemon, you're not just the fastest. You're the best.
Yeah.
Thank you, thank you. Just doing my job.
And a very excellent job.
Thanks to you, we're all gonna look gorgeous for the opening day of Mr. Longface's Croquet Country Club.
I've never played croquet.
Well, it's kind of like golf, but with wire hoops instead of holes. It's fun.
Whoa!
Look for us.
I'm so sorry. Oh, here, let me. I got it. Here, look at that. Okay, hold still. There, got it.
No, it's great.
Looks great.
Never looked better.
I love it.
Sure does. Perfect.
Ooh, thanks.
Huh? Oh, I think it's stuck.
It isn't stuck. It's locked.
Oh, goodness. I made us late and now Mr. Longface has locked us out.
I don't think he'd do that to us just for being late.
Ooh.
Plum? Raspberry, could you please give me a leg up?
Sure thing. Here you go.
That one. Oh, no, this won't do at all. A little longer there. Oh, that's wrong.
Well, he's in there.
What's he doing?
Excuse me, Mr. Longface!
Oh!
Okay, down, please.
I have to apologize, Mr. Longface. It's my fault we were late to your opening.
Oh, the apology is mine, Miss Meringue. The opening of my croquet country club is, in fact, well, not opening.
Wait, Orange, your can stacking. It gives me an idea.
What?
Maybe we need to share ideas instead of doing it all alone. Maybe instead of cooking things, I could stack fruit. The highest fruit tower in Berry Bitty World.
Yeah, and after you win, we can eat it.
You know what, Strawberry? Your poofiest highest souffle idea gives me an idea, too. Maybe I'll try a poofiest highest hairdo.
Oh, boy, that's terrific. Oh, but what about me? I'm running out of material for that big dress I'm stitching.
That's it. What about a dress with the most stitches? I mean, you've done so many of them in that big dress already, and no one can stitch faster than you.
Oh, yes! Thank you, Blueberry. I'm using it. And you know what? No one can read out loud faster than you. Why don't you go for the record of reading really fast instead of upside down and backwards and, you know...
I can't believe I didn't think of that before.
Thanks, Raspberry.
See, girls? I knew we could do it if we helped inspire each other a little.
What about you, Plum?
I don't know. What about pirouettes?
Oh, the most pirouettes in a row!
Hey, yeah!
Girls, we've got it! All our worries are over.
Awful!
Tragic!
Weird!
We're so sorry, Lemon.
My poor violets. What could have happened?
It's certainly a mystery. We'll find out how it happened.
But who would do such a thing?
Who? You think someone took your violets?
A flower thief.
Oh, good morning, Miss Meringue. You're here early today.
So are you.
Hi, good morning, Mr. Blueberry. How are you? Lemon?
Oh, my. Oh, me. Is that sadness I see?
Lemon's had a misfortune, Mr. Bloom. One of her violets went missing.
Oh, no. But how?
We don't know.
Oh, that's so sad for you. Now I feel bad, too.
I'm sure you do.
Come on, Lemon. I'll make you a pancake breakfast and wake me up fruit juice surprise at the cafe. Lemon, you don't really think that nice Mr. Bloom would do a thing like that, do you?
Of course not, but, well, didn't you see?
See what?
His garden is right next to mine.
That's true.
Well?
It's also true that we've known Barrican Bloom a long time. Lemon, you've got to be careful of accusing people. You could really hurt someone's feelings.
I'd never want that to happen. Huh. You're right, Strawberry. Barrican Bloom would never do a thing like that.
What is it, Miss Moraine?
More of my violets are missing! Stolen!
Oh, goodness me, I didn't see. I was here the whole time, but I witnessed no crime.
Well, we're actually not really sure there's been a crime. If Barrican Bloom didn't see anything, there must be another explanation.
I can kind of see Lemon's point, though, Strawberry. No one else was around all day except Barrican Bloom.
And he told me I'm his biggest competition.
Maybe he's only complimenting you.
He is nice that way.
Why do you think he would steal your violets anyway?
Because his roses win the flower show every year, and he wants to make sure he wins this year, too.
Oh, you? You come back here, you little troublemaker. Oh, Lemon, I'm so sorry about your violets. I know how much you care about them, and how awful it feels to lose something so special.
Thanks, Strawberry.
But it would feel pretty bad if someone accused you of stealing when you didn't.
I know, but why is he there all the time when no one else is?
Maybe he's there all the time working on his roses because he cares about them so much, just like you care about your violets.
Huh, that's true.
Just don't make up your mind about what happened until we can figure it out for sure, okay?
Okay, Strawberry. I'll try.